because, you know, kids are really cute and they're appealing. And they're naive and they're kind of helpless. They have those motions even that indicate helplessness. And that's associated with the natural apprehension of cuteness, right? So cuteness is big eyes, small nose, symmetrical features, baby-like features, helpless movements. That elicits sympathy and compassion, and it does it cross species, and so does the cry. And my roommate when I was in college had a niece who was quite young, about a year and a half old, I think, and we had a cat, wild cat, and it was a really fighty cat, partly because of me, because I would always play with it, and I let it fight with me quite a lot. So it was a fighty cat, and that little girl would come over and, you know, maybe she'd cry. That cat was like there right now trying to figure out what was wrong. And the cat would use its claws on me, but it would never use its claws on the little kid, you know. And I thought, well, that's indication of that cross-species cuteness, you know. And you're all attracted to that, more or less. And the more maternal you are, the more you're attracted to such things. But, you know, you see something on YouTube and you go, ah, oh, and that's like... that's so cute. It's like, yeah, it is. It appeals to exactly this. It appeals to this concomitation of infantile features, and it brings out compassion, unless you're psychopathic. So it's a good thing, but you know, it can be manipulated. That's for sure. Women actually manipulate it with makeup, which is quite sneaky and good of them. So. Anyways.